But Ty Montgomery's running the ball well. Shakiri. We ran it with them 9 times on this drive. Very surprising. The defense is looking fan-freaking-tastic. And the Sean Kaiser fumbles. And they picked it up.
Turn my computer, please. Just sit on the bed. She niggas is haters. Hey, Gary. Or not. I'm so dumb for scheduling my classes at 9:30.
Nah, bro, that's actually looking good.
Hello, everybody.
You need to get them out the way, but I'm not a morning person.
This is Madden 17 on EA Sports. We're across the pond in England this week, and two teams are hoping to show off for an international audience. It's the Armadillos going up against the Black Knights.
Would you rather have the rest of your day? Broadcast team.
Well, the rest of my days are just get working.
All right, Larry, thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Coming up, another edition of the NFL International Series, and it should be a good one, between the Austin Armadillos and the London Black Knights. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, you look at the Londoners as they get ready here. They've been buoyed by getting 2 home games right at the start, and they come off a good victory in week 1. Meanwhile, for our visiting Austin ball club, they too were winners last time out, so something's got to give here.
I love it when both teams come in off of wins. Great mindsets, and it usually leads to a really well-played game.
Then your mic probably muted if you're trying to talk.
Starts as this one is underway on EA Sports. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And a nice
and
return kind of
worked
this
in the playoffs last year.
So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And they'll be led out by a guy who has a couple years under his belt in the NFL.
Alas,
I
think this is supposed to be Sean Long.
You guys can hear me?
Yes, we can hear him.
Oh, sweet. I'm using my brother's beats and I found a chord that works. It's weird. I still have to do it.
Here we go! What?
Nothing!
Hey,
now the Georgia Southern man. This is Jarek McKinnon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it.
Alright,
but
we know about
the
viewers here.
11 yards on the pickup, and that'll be good enough for the first.
It should go without saying that anytime you run the football well and gain a nice chunk of yardage, that means the offensive line did their job and did it really well.
I wonder if anybody caught on to what I was doing on Madden defense last night.
Offensive line meetings, they're going over adjustments, counters, when they line shifts, all those things that go along with it. And yet, you still have to be physical. And that's what they did on the first play.
And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was in the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly
what'd you say
right.
I was doing,
can't
sure?
Wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Going under.
No, that's not what I was doing.
See if they stay on the
ground. I was actually playing over the top.
Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Back to throw.
Back.
He's coming and he's taken down.
My backup is.
He'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack. And it's third down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you. And you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is that you bring a running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability and a sack resulted.
He's got a man complete. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Brandon, in our meeting with the coaches prior to this game, we heard them talk about the opportunity for the deep pass. They've got a receiver who can sprint out wide. They wanted to make sure they had a chance to get it to him and loosen up the defense.
Here's McKinnon. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard
line. That defense is awful
this drive
this
is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows
better.
Guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while,
the Rangers,
I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle
the
him.
The Stars and the Cowboys have finished with the best record
here,
in the
out of the gun. For Kenner, here it's complete.
But all of them failed to make it to the
19. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
Here we go.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. A dump down to McKinnon. And now
Kendall
they're inside the
back
10 way. As he's brought down
at
the 9.
15 inches.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just
inches
here. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a
yes.
sense with him because he's had a good week of practice
yeah,
or something
Black
in that
Rowe.
Area.
He's
they
like
want
a
him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game. But they must like the matchups.
I'm going to wait till the end of the season to spend any XP that I earn.
Let's see if they're able to capitalize
so,
here.
Well, my players.
Exactly
like, I have a superstar development plan. He already has
10,000
XP.
Able to push his way forward here for a good little game.
Like
it'll
lot.
Be a pickup of 4,
yeah.
and it brings up.
So they don't get any XP really.
Let's look defensively at the starters.
Landikons is built like your typical tackle first safety, but he does have the ability
the season,
to play
so
the deep part of the field.
Don't usually winning the awards or anything like that.
He's
my nickel player.
These are nickel. They've got many good corners ahead of them.
They'll run it now, out of the
yeah,
gun.
You know, I'm 76 overall.
On
my starter is an 81 overall, second year player, and I got Marlon Humphrey.
Now third down. Can this defense get the stop on the opening drive? Here's third and goal.
This kicker that I found in the playoffs.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He's got time in the pocket.
Oh my God, bro. I can't cover two people.
They're dangerous wide receiver. His third touchdown now on the year. And this offense takes the ball down the field and scores on their opening drive. Well, that's how they envisioned it. Get the football to start the game and score it.
And I don't know if that was scripted or was it an audible? Or was it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And a glance here at their shifty mobile signal caller.
Jack.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. And a quick throw here that's complete. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
But that was well defended. And as a cornerback, what you're taught when you see a wide receiver screen, either you get underneath the play before the blocking forms, or you're going to have to fight your way through it by getting through some blocking.
I'm so glad my
really
quarterback
nice
is very accurate.
The play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
That was a nice run slam route, but the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's
he
going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field, and now what he's trying
really
to do
could throw
is use his body
though.
To keep the defender
really
away from the football and
receiver.
Get the quarterback a really nice target.
I like that one, partner. They go back-to-back with excellent gains. And really, it shouldn't be a surprise who they were throwing the ball to. He's their best guy.
Yeah, we knew that they would get him involved early. They're doubling down on getting him involved early.
Don't be surprised.
I need to start running drag routes across
the
middle.
They haven't shown the propensity
to
be able to stop
him. Well, the screen's not there.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
With one of those running backs going, we're just busting out.
That's him. Flush to his right.
The corner's not like
now he's
going to
send this one deep
right
side. And a 7-yard line, the catch is made. And a huge play that time. And even 40 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing.
those types of plays that can knock the defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
The setup to throw, buying time to his left.
And he's just that's a rough in the passer, bro. I threw the ball away a year ago. Come on now. Stop letting me kill my quarterback. Tight end's first career receiving touchdown.
His first NFL reception goes for six.
Oh, no.
And his guys are an extra point away from tying this thing up.
That's almost just not right. You cover everybody. But those tight ends, they can be awfully reliable.
Very reliable. The defense just has to hate those guys.
It just drives them crazy because oftentimes you can't match up with them. They have either with size, speed, or maybe even just strength.
Yeah.
Now Andrew Frank's on for the point after. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told.
You say he only has 2 catches?
Yep.
He trash.
So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. This will be fielded at the 8.
What are you gonna do?
And he'll be brought down at the 23, making it 24.
I have Cameron Meredith.
Cameron Meredith is just as old. I think he's older than Jarvis Landry.
No, he's not. He was the first year player when he first started the league.
Ready to take over again. And that last And that was amazing because that
drive was not the ball.
Now McKinnon, and he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard
line.
And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
Forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive lineman to create space up front, really well done.
Oh, his line is getting bold right now by Jacksonville.
Here we go! They'll look to throw here. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Man, I don't understand how we can go from dominating defensively to
sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn as it's London football begin quarter number 2, and they've got it here with the first down.
Our safety position drastically.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Second down following the run.
Tough day, tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
But yeah, you're right, it's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there.
What? That was the craziest half touchdown ever. I completely stopped it.
Well, if you look where that
and
play
I
keep
threw it over so
the
running back
had
to go beyond the ball.
Guy across from them best. On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
Not in the back, bro. We got that on the 5 yard line.
Still third down. So third down, just 1 yard to go. He'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the first down. is getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the first down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
I need to get better at playing 2K online. That's a hold.
And he's going to be taken down, but not before reaching the 15-yard line. So a little grabbing there, but this time it goes against the offense for holding. It's a loss of 10 yards on the play.
There we go.
Shipped together here from the D-line.
Let's go. Way to stop the goal line. Fucking... Let's go.
The midfield strike, they'll look to throw. Gonna throw right side here, complete. That throw good for four. It's second down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things.
Y'all can...
Yes, they can line up wide no like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Able to pick up a healthy chunk of yards, 7-yard gain, but a tough 3rd and 9 upcoming.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front, they moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's got time. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down.
It's sad. We're losing the defensive end for a reason.
Loss of 7 to bring up 4. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Oh, it's a wobbler here. This is taken at about the 14. Only 29 yards on the punt there. Definitely not his best. And out will come the offense as they take over. And here now the offense heading back out there. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously,
I'm touching Andy right now. He said all I do is play Madden.
Punch counter punch, isn't it?
And I said, go look at my Snapchat for it. He said, yeah, I saw it. It's all it is you playing Madden.
Come on, Ryan. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
Time for coaching change.
They dial it up this drive.
New team, new coach.
They'll run it now, out of the gun.
Coach,
and he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. All week in practice, they stretch, grounding, pounding the football, and they really executed it well there to get the first down.
That usually means getting back to being physical in practice, because when you emphasize pounding the football, it doesn't really come together unless you practice it the same way you're going to play
interference,
the game.
More pads,
and a whole lot of popping last week, and they got it done in the game.
What'd you say?
So pass interference, partner, with all the rule changes, it is hard to be a defender in the pass game.
Brandon is tough in college, it's a lot harder in the NFL. You can't touch him after 5 yards downfield. You can't touch him while the ball's not in the air. You can't touch him at all until the ball is at the receiver's hands. Very difficult to be a defender in today's NFL.
I'm going
able to get away. That's why you keep the legs churning, and he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Looking to throw, rolling to his right. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete.
Touchdown, Stephen Oil. 75th touchdown of his career. And we get the drive goal complete.
Wide receiver. His third touchdown now on the year. And his guys have taken the lead.
The catch and the touchdown, they were the end result of a terrific route run by the receiver.
Our weekly goal this week is only to get 100 passing yards.
Send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them.
One more left in the second. Now.
But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Third.
And the first play of the drive goes to McKinnon.
Bro, come on, bro.
Forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That's a good play by
the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30.
Orlando's actually winning. They're 1-0.
Built around the guy throwing the football, but these short
and they're
runs
beating Detroit right
still
now,
pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
See. Stay with the throw here.
And he finds a man.
Oh, come on!
He's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players. Somehow came back to football.
My backup is 20 or 26.
The game of football. You get better athleticism. Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
I'm playing in Mondo.
I don't know.
So he got his hands a little too far outside. The ref caught him through the flag. He lost nine there. That's
I said
it's in there
4:15.
Let me
say
it
four.
Going
off.
And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half.
Seattle.
My good friend Charles and I right back at you after this.
A one-yard gain can look like a disaster, but all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little
bit. I want you guys to know, I'm trading all my best players in my last year of the contest if they don't win anything.
Come back and get them the next time.
You guys are the
best. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
I'm not going to do it to Jim, because he's already off. He's not going to win.
The gun now on third down. He's going to air one out.
Jim hates me now.
And almost picked off. I guess the good news for them now, it's fourth down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense, and that fell harmlessly to the ground. I think he mishit it. Not good at all. Punt of just 24 yards there.
Oh, James,
the offense will come back onto the field.
I left my controller there for help.
Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. Okay. And he's been good. Two first half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence. Does a great deal for your team. Gives them a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Okay. Remind me in a couple minutes.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
Oh,
and that's incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Okay,
so the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up the third down.
And there's a run to be happy with.
good, solid yardage, you'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
300 career catches for you, Memorial. Say no more.
Play in this first half. Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back. An expecting pass.
You got to
move the pressure right.
Shout out to me upgrading in my players pass blocking, so now I have great time in the pocket. Yes, I did try and jump over him.
Hey, bro,
turn that trash off.
On third down, very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The
yes, trash. That boy is straight butt.
Now whistles come in.
That's
we're
it for you,
right? By the offense.
Oh,
it's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we
maybe
get to halftime.
Maybe anything about his race, right?
Looks like the defense in that press coverage cool. Here.
I actually like it.
Is he trash?
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw.
How is he trash?
Because he doesn't put out good music.
Touchdown.
That's usually how people are trash.
They're dangerous wide receiver. With his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here. But
case,
I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter.
They
don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all. Because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will
Orlando
score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and tear it into the second half.
And this will be a touchback as that sails
wait,
over the end.
Is that Buddy's not in the league anymore?
His team, he got forced retired and he's in debt.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter,
yeah,
not sure how aggressively
the
offensively they play this.
Well,
I think we'll find
that's what happens when you lose a lot of games.
When you get like 2-11, multiple years.
If you lose a lot and you relocate and you have overpaid players on your team,
it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offensive backfield.
Usually only overpaid players that are good. You overpay players that are not good and you don't win, you don't get fined. And you don't get fined. But,
who did he overpay?
I'm not even sure. That's what I was trying to figure out. We're taking him out the back of the end zone. Was it a good decision?
We traded away Andrew Webb, so there's some saving.
Honestly, that was his first problem. I don't know why he did that.
So here they come, the road
for some sad linebacker, he doesn't even have
to
anymore.
I
built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just
they really
working with them on.
With
here's
this,
what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half.
Nice first half to
beat those guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might
hey, my quarterback don't get called for, intentional grounding. I was in the pocket and I threw it away.
So the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly
really?
A big reason why they have the lead. But now,
because my quarterback has a throwaway trait.
Yeah, perhaps. And then after that incompletion, look credit to the defense for
that's
shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football.
Well,
a little
my best linebacker is super small. He's 5'11". He runs a lot of
screen there on second down certainly didn't develop how they thought. Is that one they should
why
have?
Why
did
he keep calling me
and
hanging up?
Sticks in his pocket.
I think the latter. I like what you said there because trying is one thing. We can second guess just about every call. But in this game,
and we get sacked, man. I should have threw the ball a long time ago.
Just inside the 10, back at the 9. And a play like that, with how far he had to go to make that sack, shows how athletic defensive ends have become in the NFL.
And not just athletic, this is coached in a big way. Run to the football at all times. How about him never giving up on it and pursuing all the way across the field?
Anybody go edit my fucking audibles?
You can't, bro. I tried.
They'll score that a 36-yard punt. And this offense, they're going to have excellent field position. They take over with a...
Sheer. I'm literally editing my audibles right now.
Are you doing it in the middle of the game?
Yeah.
Oh. I thought you were talking about on the menu.
Yeah, there's no way to do it on the menu. I don't know what I want to audible to, so I'm just going to leave it be.
Which is kind of stupid, so.
Wait, we can't edit our audibles?
Not
like the place.
Not on the menu.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
User! I was user in the linebacker. We must stop the pass.
Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They run once more with McCann.
Bro, they are determined to run the ball against me, bro.
Pick up there 10 yards and it'll move the sticks.
He's getting torched on the line.
I mean, he only got 50 yards, but damn, I'm sticking him on the ball.
In this case, you got a back who's quick
and
can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefit to that speed, not just outrunning people.
Oh,
you're
not gonna
have
a buddy back in the
league.
Really
nice game.
Yeah, he hasn't been there. He hasn't been home.
Where's he been?
Well, he was home yesterday, but he didn't have a controller, so I hope this both up to not be as cool. Before that, he was at his friend's house, and he didn't have home to the basketball.
Now a handoff here to his running back.
You work
and he's
going to
get this one down to the 30.
Nope.
2 yards on the carry
school.
There, and it's going to lead him to third down.
I'd be out of school.
Well, so many times
man.
We look at a short run, and we praise the offense for trying to set
work.
The tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys,
dude, I don't know if I can work Wednesday. No.
Wasn't a big run given up.
Why?
They don't always have to absorb
because
the body blows. Sometimes they dish
them
out themselves.
Like,
so second
like
down
the
was
stereo
a run
system
play.
And everything put in, like cleaned, I guess, or something. I don't know about that, but. I won't have a car, and then I have to you take Mr. out there, too?
Yeah.
Okay, and then
I have
to, yeah, because then my mom's at work, and my dad has done his practice, and I'll be, like, stuck at Skyzone.
It's officially a 55-yard attempt.
And we talk about players blitzing all the time.
I'll have to go pick up mom, yeah.
What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really
difficult.
Oh, my God.
Blake Bortles cannot throw
an
Aaron Rodgers type of pass.
Clean,
that's so fake.
The advantage definitely goes to the
defensive. He's not throwing on the run across his body.
There's an Aaron Rodgers type of pass?
The one he threw last night. That's like an Aaron Rodgers thing.
Nigga, I just sent you the address.
Ready to see what they can do here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose
that's
the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking
honestly,
for
I can't
now is a little more consistency.
Chiefs
move
lost.
The ball at least a few
like,
times on offense, get a couple of first downs.
The Chiefs can hold the Steelers to only field goals.
To build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Quick hitter here. It's
well, the Chiefs' defense is a lot better than
on
mine.
The catch. It's second and
not really a lot.
Decided to run a hitch route. But they're
better.
But
the Patriots
have
time.
Boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Score like two touchdowns or whatever it was. Or one touchdown they score.
Yeah, bro, that game last night kind of reminded me, even though we didn't watch it, the Colts
and Ravens.
Adam and Terry literally won
the game. A gain of four on the play,
yeah,
and that'll make it third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end,
really
or running backs. They can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. This is Johnson, he's got it. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first.
Oh, timeout Dumbry, 32-yard touchdown, called back.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is.
Well,
this was an excellent read.
Bro, come on, man.
Before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when you're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football.
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get into him easily. Once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Trevathan is that he traded. Four basically for Andrew Luck.
Oftentimes you see defensive, he said middle linebacker, here it's offensive holding for
the flag. I mean, that's who it is. He's on the Bills now.
Yeah, he's not even on his team.
Yeah, bro, that's why I don't understand why he should have Andrew Luck.
I pretty much got Andrew Luck for
nothing.
Yeah, I honestly...
Are you serious? How do you not... Wow. Beat the receiver. To send in a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger wrap, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it. Corey Coleman climbing the ladder.
The underneath route, they went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete.
Quarterback trying to break pocket
pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back
off. Using
so
LP.
That you can catch everything underneath, but still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right?
Hope
sometimes you have
move.
To go up and beat a
Hope
defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there.
What? The what kind of fumble was that? That was the weirdest fumble I've ever seen. And he was just like holding it and like mixing those with his fumble. Like there's no like drop.
He had to figure they had to bring some type of pressure. They had to change things up on defense.
And able to get to him, put him on the ground, so maybe just something to throw him off a little bit.
Yeah, that had to feel a lot better for the defensive guys. They've been getting carved up in this one. To finally knock him on the ground and force an incompletion, that's got to be a sigh of relief.
Forced out to his left.
Damn, bro, they're bringing a hell of pressure.
This will be incomplete.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure
and
it creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes.
That's what he's going for.
They
got
what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to choke
away. That's what's
going
to lead.
They'll look to throw.
And they blitzed again.
Oh,
he's going to get it.
It's complete. Yeah. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And
did,
on fourth down,
anybody
play
Jackson
over
this year?
And move the sticks. And the seemingly endless drive continues.
We always hear about guys wanting to make plays that
it's like the very only player.
And he fires. Bro, what the fuck kind of shit is that, bro?
And he's going to take this one back
to the 37-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
The drive starts with a handoff to McKinnon.
I don't understand how my defensive line is not.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
That's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
That's coverage set.
There's McKinnon on the draw. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. He lost four there, and it's third down.
With the struggles
for some reason, it says I have a nickel 4-3, but I don't see it.
They've got to think about up their play calling. Some screens,
that
some draws, some
off.
Quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon
but
it,
I need
but
that
try and give it a little bit of help.
9 yards to go. It's third down.
First
down. They're down 29 points, and they're really trying to do this hurry-up offense and score and all stuff.
Back
out.
To throw here. And some room to run now.
Bro, this game is so gay, dude.
He's got some space now.
Oh, my God. Stop texting me the same things over and over, dude.
Welcome back now here in London. As we've got the final quarter upon us, we get ready to start the fourth.
Garbage.
And down to the 36-yard line here. A solid run on first down.
That
gain of
really
seven
bad.
Leaves him with a second and three.
That was a good run, and it got to the second run. And what
I
mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually
play.
First level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making
it
tackle.
And oftentimes decided to run
them a hybrid.
Well, you guys think they definitely can do it for the QB situation.
Linebacker make the stop.
Calling a game, it's 7-0 to 2 set of downs.
Tyrod Taylor was the starter, but Rex Ryan got fired, and now that's his name. So they want to get it around.
What better quarterback can you find out?
They'll look to throw here that's on first down.
Because there's not much, though.
I mean, they went with DJ Manuel, and then I don't know what happened. Just what's his name? For me.
Doesn't even become a weapon.
That Cardell. And here comes play number six on this drive. He fucking sucks. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him the football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
He's throwing those things, He's 21 carries for 78 yards.
This is fucking ridiculous.
Get on my nerves, bro, because he keeps throwing the ball.
Oh my god, who would have caught that?
That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
This is damn near a super
team,
though.
This will be the eighth play of the drive, and it's third and inches. Down here in the red zone, you know your tight end's going to be a favorite target. Couldn't hang on.
And sometimes they just have to get out of their own head, because they understand how tight windows are there,
and how many bodies are there,
and sometimes they just overthink it and don't catch the ball.
So third and inches, trying to pick it up, up the middle. He had nowhere to go, tackled for a loss.
And you know how we talk about double A-gap pressure, meaning linebackers going in the gap between the center and the guard on either side? Well, it's not always to get to the passer. Sometimes you do that to prevent a running play. Worked pretty well in that situation.
Game over.
And Boswell's kick is good.
Wow, they had the ball a lot more than that.
Ridiculous. All right, so you needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe
you
not
see that
exactly
Cowboys
what they wanted, but
it's a necessary first step. Well, you get that TV with a mean-ass combo.
I
really
was so he was fucking lighting that TV up. Well,
we just fumbled and the damn kickoff.
When you kick off and you go downfield and get the ball back, man.
Should I ask Dudley if he's with Jamie?
In a one-score game, I always circle, you know this, but in my play-by-play sheet, I circle big plays. It could be turning points. This could be a turning point.
Did you put a second circle around this? Or this
put a star. Put a star. Looking for the end zone. And he'll toss this one incomplete.
Well,
How many times when we see an incomplete pass,
I just didn't know because... she put on her Snapchat story how thick Bays, that was her, and she was like laying in bed.
Pretty solid. Start there on first down.
That gave him a little extra confidence there, starting as you said in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down.
So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion.
But dude.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
I'm not going for that Josh again, man. They lost two when it brings up four.
Brandon, and thinking along with the offensive coordinator here, I think he felt like he could pop one big because the defense has been aggressive today. Instead, he figured it out and made a nice play.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
What good could be this time? Oh, shit.
Try it here. He's back to throw.
Screen, and we get the sack. Wrap him up.
A big time sack there. Wow. Down. In there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
And so,
back out comes the offense. Looked like they had
Antonio Brown could be fine because he had a live Facebook video.
Coach, what's his name? Tomlin called the Patriots asshole or something. But,
don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember
the damn.
Forget the back.
In the last eight Nick games, they've lost by 1.3 times.
And Derrick Rose got fouled on the fucking last shot and they didn't call it.
And then they tried to play something up.
You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yard runs, and goes to one of those.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take. It's a little bit more pressure.
Well, their defense is so good, man.
And lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. They lost two there, and it's third down.
You want me to run play at your first shot? It was on my screen twice, three times. You want to run it?
We talk about it in the NFL, and a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position.
Feeding oil.
A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties.
I'm just going to upgrade my players, codes, and
offenses, and now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one. I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame.
I hate how I throw a lob on a drag route. When we go to practices, I'm trying to lead them.
Practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
And as soon as I catch the ball, I get tackled.
For these situations, first down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Bro, it really it's really mine. It's just really wild how he's staying that quick.
Rose.
I think this is probably the quickest I've seen him since those injuries.
And the defense in desperate need of a stop. They have to get off the field and get the ball back to their offense if they want a chance.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up the first down.
The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead.
Knicks fans, do you want to trade Melo? Yes, rebuild around KB. KP, no, Melo needs to stay.
But you gotta figure now, they're gonna see
you can still rebound it. Rebuild around KP with Melo on the team.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
This nigga fumbled again. They're about to take it. You know, they're gonna have no play back there. That's my third fucking turn of the day.
Close to the 40-yard line.
All I know, partner, is that with every play call that came in, there was a little discussion about, hey, we can seal this bad boy. We can really put ourselves in a great
last
spot.
Last man to walk on the moon has died.
And yet they find a way to cough it up.
Yeah, the two-score Twitter game moments. Opportunity eludes them, and now a chance for the other side to come
one
back.
One of the biggest Gators ever spotted.
To go out there and make some
and you see, that thing is crazy.
Let's see if the defense is mentally ready to take care of it.
Bro, it's in Central Florida. Florida, it's called a hunchback. Oh my God, bro. It's a dinosaur, dude.
Bro,
oh my God, bro.
And they're running no huddle. Oh my God.
Bro, that thing's as long as a snake and as big as a freaking dinosaur.
Interception.
Damn, they're longer than a snake.
Bitch ass nigga.
Oh my God, bro. That would suck, bro, to like beat. Oh my God, bro. That just makes me like cringe a little.
This is a great player defensive to me.
And my man. And that could be enough to help get them out of here with a victory.
Finding his safety valve here. It's complete. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready.
Tim Belichick. Tim Belichick. Bill Belichick said, as you know, I'm not on snap pace and all that, so I don't really get those. He's talking about like Tomlin's huh?
Are you kidding me, bro? Oh my God, this nigga just ran around my blocker and made the tackle.
It was a Creighton one by five. Deion Sanders said that Julio Jones will destroy you. To who? To him, bro. Like he's just like media. It says right here, if you don't do something about Julio Jones, he will destroy you.
Guys, tune in to this game. We got a great one here in London. 21-13.
Are you James?
Honestly, he might be the best receiver in the NFL.
And we'll see what he can do on the return.
I think he is.
Officially, that'll be a 63-yard punt.
Yes, true.
Well done. And the offense will take
Jarvis Landry.
Set of downs.
So out now comes the offense back. Matt, I don't know though, because
they're down here in a one-score game. Did Roden have only like foot and toe injury?
Yeah, he probably has a lot better numbers. Like, it's really not, because this amount of time
gives them a chance to run their offense to go through play sequences. I'm top five in both defense and offense so far.
Honestly, that's really nice. They go
over this type of a situation. Oh no, I'm looking at legacy now.
They have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Team stats.
That is really funny that I do not have a face to block here. No timeouts. Give a ton of credit to making the catch and finding a way to get to the sideline. They're looking baking off right now. And they don't even got their best receiver.
I'm third in offensive yards. He'll be taken down, but not
before getting this inside the 30. They literally just run four vertical downs. And you can't go far. They get to the line. It's fucking ridiculous.
I'm straight in defensive yards, second in offensive yards, 10 some points scored, 12 in points allowed.
Jeremy Langford's about to have 100 yards in the season. What? They'll look to throw. Nathan Sidney, almost over 1,000 yards for a backup. I like that. Second year backup, getting the job done.
Baby, this is a freaking Cody Romo and Dak Prescott situation, and you need to trade, bro.
I might need to get rid of Andrew Luck. He might be the future of this team. Hey, Alshon's still getting the catches, he's just not getting the yards. Alright, making the reception receiver, I guess. Remaining now. And right now, I take my rudimentary
kindergarten skills and draw where the tackle box would be. I really drafted some stud left in for the box. He has to be very careful where he gets rid of the football from that spot.
Yeah, they say there was a receiver in the area, though.
Yeah, there's always a receiver in the area.
So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on 3rd and 10. They'll look to throw. Surveying the field. And this is caught.
Oh my God, bro, you gotta be kidding me. It's cover three.
Dak Prescott had 9 touchdown passes in 2018.
Bro, that's what I wanna know, bro. That's unreal.
It
was against Buddy.
It was
against a user team, because it
wasn't me. If it was, you guys, I would say,
I know I beat Dallas.
It was against Buddy, W, or Fabi. Time really dwindling in this when they were tanking. Now their big deal is make sure they get a good kickoff and don't give up anything. 2 seconds left, we'll have to keep the Hail Mary to feeding oil.
Who's the Armadillos? No, Buddy. It's Deontay, because all three, you, me, and W, our quarterbacks all have 8, and then Dak has 9. I'm looking at this in the game record right now.
They're lining up in 2-man deep.
Oh, shit. That's Kimba Marshall. That's when he fucking had that crazy
game. Oh, my God, bro. How is that an interception?
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Nothing but two teams. This will be taken about the 12. On my comment.
It's like everybody in this league is an asshole. You have to be the player for it. Coaches don't become head coaches by being nice. Now this offense ready to take over again. They control. You guys ever think Brandon Marshall's 21 catch record would be broken?
And I think teams around the
league, I don't know, bro. Antonio Brown hit like 17 last year. I think it was against Denver, actually.
And trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Oh, wow. Leonard
Fournette broke the rushing record in that game.
Yeah, he won the MVP.
Charles on the slant. You always need good ball placement. They got it there.
Brandon, the quarterback, put it in the exact perfect spot. Right to the upfield shoulder of the receiver. And he used his body to keep the defender away.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And no room that time. Getting it to about the 46. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight. When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him.
Guy playing the middle
linebacker. Hey, I'm 2-0.
We went
2-0. That means the defensive front is eating up all the blocks. And just let him go to the ball and make the play. Yeah, he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the game.
Yeah,
and it's third and two now.
I'm playing right now. It's an overtime.
But you gotta know that he feels like he's right on the verge. And that's probably exactly what he's telling
them to do right now.
I'm trying to focus. I'm not looking at that.
Okay. Yeah, Antonio Brown caught 16 passes for 189 yards.
Yes! Let's go! The Pro Bowl linebacker! 4th and 2, punt the ball!
But I think it's safe to say that pressure could get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure.
You guys aren't. You guys need to tune in. This is a great game.
Best of the day. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. And here now the offense.
Next score wins the game.
Their defense did its job. Got the stop. All they need is 3, and this is over.
Couldn't have done much else other than score themselves and end it. But they turned it back over to him, and now all they need is a field goal.
Leonard Fournette is a dog in overtime. Leonard Fournette is a dog in overtime. Touchdown in the first play. He wants to win. Game over.
And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime.
Whoever just tuned in, you're a little too late.
What you're gonna expect when you come to the stadium to call a game. Sometimes you get good ones, sometimes you get bad ones, sometimes you get great ones, and that's what
power is the way. Don't ask.
Bro, they've been missing blocks that entire game, bro. Entire game. We finally came up with the biggest block of the game. We had 3 fumbles. Fumble on a kickoff, in the red zone, and somewhere else. And we threw an interception.
It's going to give you the play we saw to win the game.
But I know everyone's thinking that that was something they just drew up.
What?
It might have been something they've been working on, and now they got the right matchup.
Hello? What are you saying? I found... Oh, I can't hear. Let me turn my volume up. Say it again. Say it again. All right. All right, peace.